let's look at the nucleus of the set, the bass drum, snare drum, and hi-hat. And I remember hearing this great story by one of my mentors and really drumming inspirations, JoJo Mayer. And he had said once he went 6 months where he literally took the pieces of his drum set, put them in a corner, and he only had bass, snare, hi-hat. And for 6 months straight, he only played with that. And that is such a great way to practice in a discipline. I've done that myself. If you listen to the album Collection by James Brown called Star Time, I always recommend that to everybody in the LTR drumming worldwide community. Just put that on for like a lifetime. The drummers are Jabbo Starks and Clyde Stubblefield. And really, they're creating magic with 99% hi-hat, snare, bass drum. And it's just like that should be the core. That should be so strong in your drumming, where like all this other stuff is icing on the cake. It all just enhances the core of my rhythmic expression. Here's an inspiring story from outstanding drummer and educator Mike Johnston. And he was challenged by his teacher and mentor to go to the root and the nucleus of this instrument, the bass drum, doom, 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 the snare drum, da, 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 and the hi-hat, ch, ch, ch. And just what we can do with those three sounds. And you notice I'm able to sing those sounds and create really like a tapestry and a painting using just those three sounds. So there's a lot of other drummers that the best you'll notice they're able to say what they can play. So check out this story by Mike Johnston, where he shares how he did an entire tour with his band only using those three sounds. So he really stepped up to go deep into this to explore his possibility and potential and rise onto what he could do in the drum set. And that's what it's really all about. All great artists, musicians, they go deep with a little bit. They're able to do a lot with a minimalist approach. And if you think of Picasso, where he had his blue period, where he only painted in blue, that's a great example of doing a lot with a little. So get inspired by Mike Johnston and see what you can do with just those three sounds to express your rhythmic heart.
My teacher, Pete Magadini, when I was just starting to tour professionally, like when my band got signed, I just started studying with Pete. And he said, okay, we're just going to be on kick, snare, and hats and a ride for a while. And I was like, what? And I had a pretty big kit at the time. And I was like, okay, well, yeah, I can practice on that at home. He's like, no, that's all I want you to play. I'm like, well, I'm headed out on a six-month tour. Like, I'm not going to not take toms. He's like, if you want to study with me, you're not going to take toms. So I had to go tell my band, you know all that thunderous floor tom stuff? It's not going to be on this tour. And I mean, it didn't go down well, that's for sure. But I was committed more to getting better as a player than I was to anything else. And I trusted Pete. And so, yeah, so I did like 6 months with no toms, no crashes, just a ride right over my kick drum, hi-hats and snare. And my goodness, like I grew so much trying to make that thing sound good.